Hello students, we will continue with part 2 of the chapter New Kings and Kingdoms. We will come to the topic now, a closer look at the Cholas. Now till now in the chapter we were discussing about dynasties in the northern Indian part. Now we'll be talking about Samans or the new dynasties which grew and became big empires in the southern Indian part. So the topic is from Uriyar to Tanjore. Now we'll come to the notes. Earlier in this area, there was a minor chiefly family known as Mutriyar held power in the Kaveri Delta. Now these Cholas were Samans earlier of the Pallava dynasty, which was ruling here. And these Cholas were subordinate to the Pallava kings of Kanchipuram. So Pallava's capital was the Kanchipuram. Now Vijayala of the Cholas from Uriyar captured the delta from the Mutriyars in the middle of the 9th. He built the town of Tanjore and the temple for goddesses Nisubasaduni here. So he built a temple. This temple's name will be asked, and it is built for which goddesses? This can be asked in exams. The successors of Vijayala conquered the neighboring regions, and the kingdom grew in size and power. Another ruler, now when the Cholas established their empires, now one of the most important kings, whose name is Rajaraja I, was considered the most powerful Chola ruler and expanded control over most of these areas. So this Chola empire, which we can see in the map, this was extended under Rajaraja I. His son Rajendra I conquered Sri Lanka and countries of Southeast Asia, developing a navy for these expeditions. So Rajaraja did not go outside India, but Rajendra I, he crossed the sea and he conquered Sri Lanka, countries of Southeast Asia such as Indonesia, Malaysia, Myanmar. All these areas came under Rajendra I. And this was all possible because he had developed a navy for all this. Now we come to splendid temples and bronze sculptures. This was the most, you can say, the quality of technology which had developed under the Cholas. Cholas were big temple builders. Two famous temples in Tanjore and Gangai Koda Cholapuram built by Rajaraja and Rajendra. So one temple was built by Rajaraja and another temple at Gangai Konda Cholapuram. This was the capital built by Rajendra. So he had built a temple out here. Temples were not only places of worship, they were the hub of economic, social and cultural life as well. So now what happens? How did the temples become a hub of economic, social and cultural life? For example, a king is constructing a temple. Temple is being constructed by the people who has been employed by the king. Now, with that, what happens? They start living around the temple. Later on, a market also develops and around the temple. And slowly and steadily, a town develops. A city starts to emerge around the temple. So this is how the temples became a hub of economic, social and cultural life. Chola bronze images are considered amongst the finest in the world. Chola images, I'll just show you in the book, the Chola images. These are the temples. First, let me come to the bronze. This is a bronze image. Now, this was a very good technology used by the Cholas, and this has been famous all over the world. Now, I was talking about the temples. This is a temple in Gangai Konda Cholapuram. Now, these huge temples try to show the kings very powerful, wealthy, and try to show that the empire was really big. Now we come to agriculture and irrigation. What were the developments under the Cholas in agriculture and irrigation? New developments in agriculture. The river Kaveri deposited fertile soil. If we go back to the map, this is the river Kaveri. And the region around Kaveri was very fertile. It was only from the 5th or the 6th century that this area was opened up for large scale cultivation. Because when forests were cleared, That area was developed as agricultural land and large scale cultivation started. Forests were cleared, land was leveled, and embankments to prevent flooding. So there were banks built on the river sides so that there is no excessive flooding. Canals were built, wells were built for irrigation purpose. Tanks were constructed to collect rainwater, and this water was used for irrigation as well as for consumption. Rulers and the people took active interest in irrigational and agricultural activities. So rulers and the people both took interest in irrigational and agricultural activities. So this all led to the development of the land. Now we come to the administration of the empire. What was the administration of the Cholas? Settlements of peasants known as Urd became prosperous with the spread of irrigation agriculture. So peasants who were known as Urd became prosperous, and they became prosperous, wealthy because of the spread of agriculture with the facility of irrigation. Groups of such villages formed large units called Nadu. So now these Urd, many Urds came together, a group of Urds came together, and they formed a larger unit which was called Nadu. The village council and the Nadu had functions including such as dispensing justice and collecting taxes. Now this Nadu, which a larger unit has been formed, this they used to have an assembly. So this assembly was acting as a justice, delivering justice, collecting taxes and all this, and it was controlling all these group of Urs. Now these rich peasants of the Velala caste exercised control over the affairs of the Nadu. So the rich peasants, they were known as Velalas. Out here in this book, it has been, the word Velala has been used, and they controlled over the affairs of these Nadus. The Chola kings gave some rich landowners titles like Muvendu Velam, a Velan or peasant serving three kings, Ariyas, chiefs, etc. So, Brahmanas received land grants or Brahmadeya. So the land which the Brahmanas were receiving under the Cholas came to be called the Brahmadeva. Each Brahmadeva was looked after by an assembly or sabha of prominent Brahmana landlords. Associations of traders known as Nagrams performed administrative functions in towns. So the traders in the town, they formed the association, a group, and that group came to be known as Nagrams, and they performed administrative functions also for the town, for the development of the town. The Sabha had separate committees to look after irrigation works, gardens, temples, etc. So for the development of the town, they were looking after all these things. Names of those eligible to the members of these committees were written on small tickets of palm leaf and kept in an earthenware pot, from which a young boy was asked to pick the tickets one by one for each committee. We were talking about these committees. For example, a committee is for a Nadu or for a Nagram. So how were the members appointed for these councils or the committees? So the names of all the members who wanted to be members of that committee were kept in an earthen pot, and a small boy was asked to pick one by one. And whichever the name was which came, they were selected as members of the committee. So students, with this we come to the end of the chapter.